Folks, Dagan here from PMTVUK, and today I have the absolute pleasure of showcasing for you the brand new, as of recording this video, BOSS ME-90B bass multi-effects pedal. Let's get into it. So, the BOSS ME-90B, the ME-90G, or the regular ME-90, the guitar version of this has been out for a little while now, and everyone bloody loves it. So, BOSS have done what they do best and listened to their audience, listened to the people that buy their gear, and they brought out a bass version. There hasn't been a bass version of a BOSS ME product in a little while, and now they're back, and better than ever, with the ME-90B. And boy is it packed full of features, but it's super easy to use. And that's the whole point of the BOSS ME range, whether it be the 90 or the old school. I've got a BOSS ME-70 in the house and I love it and use it to this day. It's for the guys and gals out there that want a lot of stuff for like a multi-effects and with built-in amps and stuff. But you don't want to have to scroll through menus and go digital deep dive and stuff. It's laid out. All the BOSS ME stuff are laid out like a compact pedal. Everyone knows how to use BOSS compact pedals, like the ones you can see on screen right there. There's knobs on the front, tells you what to do. Easy as that. The ME-90 is essentially just loads of BOSS pedals all in one. It's the easiest thing in the world to use and it sounds fantastic. And it's not just the super easy user interface that resembles compact pedals, which makes the ME-90B awesome. It's the fact that the entire thing has been optimized for bass. A lot of the time with some other multi-effects and bass specific stuff, they kind of just put the guitar, like put a bass logo on the guitar things. Like their guitar choruses will work for bass and stuff. All the effects, all the amps, all the inputs and the outputs have been tuned and optimized to work specifically for bass. That may sound lovely and heavy, but the unit itself isn't heavy at all. It weighs just under 3 kilos, which is about 6 pounds, I think. So it's gig ready. What I love about the BOSS ME stuff as well is the fact that it's nice and thin, like low profile, so they easily slip into the front pockets of gig bags. Granted, that might stick out a little bit, but it's not going to be big and bulky and stuff. You haven't really got to have a separate bag. You can do if you want, but it'll easily slide into the pocket of a gig bag. And also, it runs on batteries if you wanted to as well. Standard BOSS power cable or 4 AA batteries have this tone, but anywhere and not have to power it up. Fantastic. Now let's not forget that BOSS actually invented the multi-effects unit back in 1983. That's what ME stands for, multi-effects. So they know a thing or two about how to set them up, make them easy to use, and make them sound absolutely awesome. Whether you're rocking this, like I said before, in your gig bag, taking it to schools, whether you're at college and you want a great sounding bass tone to take wherever you want, or you want to play Wembley Stadium, these little guys, the ME-90Bs, will deliver on tone and continue to be as easy to use as ever. So let's talk about how I'm setting it up right now today. So, one thing to note with this, with the bass version, is there's an XLR out. So that's a common thing, like the bass DI and stuff. There's an XLR out, and I'm going straight into a PA speaker and then into your lovely ears through a little zoom thing out the back of that thing, down there on the floor. If you're new to the world of bass, XLR out of a unit on the floor is a super common, super easy way to get your bass tone out there. DI, essentially, with all the tones and effects that you want. Everyone does it, and now you can do it with a BOSS ME-90B. However, if you don't want to run it that way, if you want to run it into an amp or something, there are stereo quarter-inch jacks out and a little switch next to it, so you can actually tell it whether you want to put cabinet emulation on, if you want to run through the XLR, or into an amplifier to switch through to the amplifier mode setting thing, and then you're good to go that way. It also features an effects loop. Since I'm talking about all the ins and outs of the ME-90B, as well as a headphone output, so you can plug headphones in and silently get all the tones of your ME-90B into your cans, as well as a USB-C input/output. Now, this is quite cool because you can use the ME-90B as an audio interface to get all your awesome BOSS tones straight from here into your computer, into your recording software. Or you can use it to manipulate some of your parameters and presets of your tones within this via the BOSS Tone Studio app for desktop. I'm going to talk about that more in a second. Now let's actually talk about the controls, what all these knobs and switches do. It can look a bit intimidating, but it's really, really not. I didn't intend to play Kansas there, but Kansas is what came out. Anyways, it's kind of split into 8 little sections, very similar to the ME-90 and other previous BOSS ME products. Set into 8 sections here, corresponding with the foot switches, besides this one. I'm going to use this as the 8th foot switch. All this guy does up here is, if you hold it down, it's a tuner. Like, have a gander at that. See how tuned I am? It's a tuner. But that guy switches between manual mode, which I'm in right now, which means everything works as if you're using, like, multi-compact BOSS effects pedals, or memory mode, which rocks presets, which again I'll talk about more later on in the video. Everything's timestamped at the bottom as well, so you can skip to that if you want. But yes, these little sections, as you can see, got the preamps and the EQs up here, modulations up here, got your compressors, effects 1, filters, effects 2, drives and synths, delays and reverbs, and each of these little sections right here, each of the little partitioned bits, obviously, as you can see, have one main notched control. It doesn't look any different to the other controls, but it's notched, and you can see that switches between the different types of that effect, whether it be a filter, modulation, or an amp. That was a very fuzzy example. It's as simple as that. It's ridiculously simple to use these pedals. It is like having just tons of BOSS compact pedals, which, like I said at the start, everyone knows how to use, but built into one unit. And they made it super easy to adjust the parameters of those effects, because like I say, you've got the one notch one to choose between that effect of each of the different segments. You've got level, tone, and the other parameter change. And as you can see, the actual parameter changing in real time thanks to that little screen over there on the right. So, what have you got? You've got compressor, filters, drives, delays, and also blend up here, which is controlled by this guy. Now what this does is brings in your dry signal. Reverb on there, isn't it? So why would you want that? Some people enjoy having a dry signal, so that's not affected by anything. That's simply the dry signal, as if I was plugging straight into a mixing desk or a PA system or something like that. That's what that does. It works great for distorted sounds. So if I was to go to a distorted amp, having a blender's dry signal alongside it just gives it a bit more oomph and a bit more clarity. Compared to, which still sounds great, obviously, but You get that clank, especially for hard rock, metal sounding bass, saturated bass tones, just makes it cut through that a little bit more. Now let's talk about the actual sound of the BOSS ME-90B. Everything it can do is all fun, but the actual sound, the actual tone, the actual essence of the amps and the effects is just phenomenal for the price of it. It's just awesome. As you can see from the logo just down there, just like the ME-90 guitar version, this features air technology. BOSS's air technology, which is augmented impulse response dynamics, which means the effects and the amplifiers, they're all taken from BOSS's flagship series of units as well, all have the response and the dynamics that you expect. It doesn't feel like you're plugging into a digital plugin from 2005 or something. It feels like you're playing something real. The air's moving around you. It reacts to the pick or fingers there. Everything's very responsive, and that's all thanks to that air technology. It's just great, like, again. Sounds like you're playing along to your favorite records. It doesn't feel synthetic, it feels real. BOSS are industry leaders at this kind of thing, and it's all thanks to that air technology, which of course you'll find in the ME-90B. So let's give you a quick little demo and a sample of each different section, starting with the amplifiers you can choose up top. There's tons of amps and effects in this, it's bloody fantastic, and everything, they'll scratch every itch, they'll tickle every fancy, they will suit any genre or style you want to play. There's a tone for you in the ME-90B, I promise. There's even a straight up EQ. That's just the bass coming straight through to the PA, and you can alter the bass, middle, treble, high frequency, treble, and level, all with controls down the bottom there. So there's an EQ if you don't want to use any amplifiers, but the amps in this are just... fantastic sounding thing. That. I like that one. Solid stack. That's like an old school bass sound, isn't it? There's even a setting for acoustic bass. If you want to use acoustic bass here, which is next to the EQ. Doesn't turn your bass into an acoustic bass, but what does turn your bass into an acoustic bass is, let's go back to a normal natural bass tone, is down here on the compressor slash effects one unit. Let's nuzzle on over to this. There's actually an acoustic bass simulator. It gives you a bit more low end, like the resonance of a sparkly top, like a maple top or something. Do that going into the EQ. Here it there, so there's no amp, just an acoustic bass. Obviously there's tons of compressors. Compressors are very important in the world of bass. There's also fun effects like octaves and poly octaves. You can do like an organ thing almost. I also feel that with the bass octaves, it's very organy, very, very musical. There's also cool stuff like the S bend or ring modulators. I hate ring modulators, but damn the fun. I shouldn't say I hate ring modulators, it's just. How can you hate that though? Yeah, but S bend is one of my favorite Boss effects. It's when you haven't got a whammy pedal. Notice that it turns off, so it's on all the time when you go to S bend. Turns off so you can go. And you can control the speed in which you go up and down with these controls right there. There is tune down, so. If you're in a band and you want to tune your entire bass down. Those kind of things. It's a barrel of laughs and loads of fun. Moving over to the effects, FX2 and all the filters and stuff. All the auto wars and those kind of things, all the way through to the slow gear and harmonizers. I love the slow gear one. That's... what slow gear does is slowly bring in your note you're playing. Sounds very cool. There's overtones, so like organ, again, more organy. Very kind of. Cracking. I mean, these are all the novelty ones. It does do stuff that's just regular. Drives and synths, obviously you've got like fuzzes I spoke about before. All the way through to the synth sounds that I showed you at the intro. Fantastic. What is not to love? What is not to, what's regular down here? Regular boost, if you just want a boost. On the signal you already have. So put a bit of grit on the amp. Kind of grit, but you've got the overdrive. If you want to, these are all Boss's most famous overdrives and distortions and metal pedals as well. So distortions and synths with that. Right at the end, you got the delays and reverb. There's been a bit of reverb on this whole time. Just like a hole, all the delays and stuff. Pretend you're the edge from you two. We all know how delays work and stuff, but there is terror echoes, so. All of Boss's most fun effects, as well as the regular run-of-the-mill ones, you'll find in the ME90. Moving up to all the modulation effects, your standard choruses, phases, flanges, and the rest. Points if you're going to name that song. There's also a separate delay and compressor up here, because a lot of the times if you want to use, say, the octaves in this and a nice reverb, but you also want delay or extra compression, you can have it on the modulation wheel up here. So there is duplicates of some things, just so you can keep those staples of delay and compression if you want to utilize other effects within the ME-90B. Right, last thing I want to talk about, well, a couple of last things. The expression pedal on the right, that has their own fun, that has its own fun little bunch of effects down here. Like, you use it as a whammy pedal, you use it to bring the rate of the delay in and the modulation and stuff, the same modulations and the same octaves you heard before. All the crazy things like that, but if you just want to use it as a wah, you can, or a, it comes from the factory as a volume pedal. Three of the best features, I think, of the expression pedal, like the effect that's solely for this, is the you can bring in the blend control, bring in the dry signal, like I was saying earlier, you can do it with the knob by turning it on here, or there's the, where's the oscillating delay, which is, well, this is what it says on the tin. Same as having an old like DD3 or something and just playing with the time and the repeat control. It's that but on an expression pedal. Super creative way of making something musical out of something so chaotic. And you've got the freeze as well, which freezes whatever you've done so you can play over the top of it. So you play something while depressing it. It'll hold that no matter what you do over the top. Affected and to get rid of it, just pull it back. Super fantastic little feature, and you can fiddle with it all with your feet. Right, so everything you've heard up to now has all been in manual mode. So that's using it as if it's just loads of BOSS compact pedals on the floor. We can actually save your sounds as presets. So press the memory manual, that switches over to memory mode, and notice there's obviously compression, filter, drive, synth, delay, reverb, but above that you've got numbers. That's four presets, and there's banks you can go up and down here. Notice the little screen change with the numbers. Use it U and P, all the way through, four presets within each. I don't know what these are. It's what comes with it. It feels like an electric guitar, it's pretty cool. So you can get pretty wacky with it. You can save any... any combination of effects, amp models, compression, delays, whatever, all within this. So those are the presets, and you can save and edit your presets with the controls right here on the right. Write them into a place to save them where you want to save them, and do it all through the actual unit itself. But the last thing I want to talk about is one of the coolest things about BOSS in general and the ME-90 range. And so like I said earlier, when you USB this into your computer, you can get BOSS's Tone Studio for your desktop and edit and manipulate your parameters and your presets all through your computer. Do it that way. So you can do it on the front, obviously, but if you want to delve a bit deeper and see things in real time and change parameters and stuff, you can do it all via the app on the computer. And that's also the same for the presets. You can move the presets to different places, you can save them, you can delete them. Not only that, you can download stuff from BOSS's Tone Exchange, which is a huge online library of tones that people have created. Celebrity bass and guitar players as well have created that you can download and download it into your very own ME-90B. So save and use from a whole library in BOSS's Tone Studio, or manipulate the parameters a little bit more using the editor by USBing it into your computer and using the BOSS Tone Studio desktop app. Next up though, if you want to do it wirelessly, you can get the optional BOSS BT Dual, the little Bluetooth adapter, and plug it at the top of your ME-90B, and then wirelessly change the parameters through the app you can get for your phone. And the BOSS Tone Studio app you can get for any mobile device or whatever, Bluetooth to your ME-90, save presets, download from the library, everything wirelessly with the BOSS BT Dual adapter. But not only that, you can then stream audio from your device through your ME-90B. So you can jam along with backing tracks, play along with YouTube videos, play along with your band sounds and stuff, all coming through this into your speaker or your headphones wirelessly through the BT Dual wireless little bug thing you can get. I'll link everything in the description box down below, obviously, so you can check everything out at pmtonline.co.uk. And I do believe that's it. Comment down below, let us know what you think. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up and hit subscribe. We are playing music today on all social media platforms. I've been Dagan. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.